Hey guys, Crystal Thompson here for Unity. Today on Color Combos for Crystal, we have a very simple card tutorial. We're going to be using the Funny Farm stamp set. This is a gorgeous animal stamp set with a couple sentiments. For our color combos, we're using white, red, and black. The main stars is the liquid masking fluid, washi tape, and you're going to need some ink blenders. We're going to begin by stamping the Funny Farm animals onto our card base that's been pre-cut 4.25 by 5.5. I really love this image. It's really gorgeous, kind of farm look. Then we are going to stamp the sentiment, and it says hello from the Funny Farm. Now we're going to be doing the masking with liquid masking fluid. So liquid masking fluid does the same thing as masking with a post-it note or a piece of paper, but instead of having a fussy cut, you use the liquid over your image. When using liquid, you really want to make a very, very light layer of this liquid because it kind of does take a little bit to dry. It took me about 5 minutes. Once it's dry, it turns into a bit of a yellow tingy, and don't worry, it will come off. Then using our washi tape or purple tape, we are going to start some stripes, and we're going to start top to bottom from the left to the right, and we're going to do some diagonal stripes, trying to really keep the space in between nice and even. Then we're going to come across to the other side, the other direction, and leaving some space for squares. So the space in between is going to create a checkered look. Again, try to really get those even. And if they're not, that's okay. I mean, you are doing a DIY background. This is a great way to add dimension without having to fussy cut and do foam adhesive. Also makes it super easy to sand this card without having to pay extra postage. All right, we're going to grab our red ink and we're going to begin doing some ink blending. The biggest tip I can give you when you're using ink blending and masking fluid is that you dab your color onto the image that has been masked instead of doing that circular motion. The reason why the circular motion will rub off the masking fluid, which in turn will avoid the whole reason for using masking fluid. So once you've dabbed the color on that masked area, we are going to do the circular blending on the rest of the card to really get those colors. Once that's done, we're going to begin peeling off the tape to expose the gorgeous checkered background that we've created. One of the tips I can give you on this is that you pull sideways or roll it instead of pulling up. As you see here shortly, I actually ended up tearing my cards up because I pulled up. So roll or pull to the side, and that way you avoid some of that tearing. So you can see there are the little squares over our exposed image. And as you can see, it comes off with the masking fluid. So again, this is another way to mask your images without having to fussy cut, and especially this stamp set that has a lot of little details that would be kind of hard to cut those little legs to create a masked image. You can use a masking fluid, and we also used it on the sentiment. So as you can see, you can just roll it off with your finger. If you don't like the feeling, you can use an eraser. One of those large pink erasers to take it off. When you are rubbing off, be sure that your ink color is completely dry so you don't add any smudges to your card. And that does it. You can finish up with embellishments, some sequins, or black nouveau drops. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you've enjoyed this quick tutorial. Be sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know your thoughts. Have a great day.